On one hand, Lindsey was ecstatic to be having a new room, but on the other, she was kind of sad to see her old room go. She absolutely adored the care. Bare wallpaper with the Muppet Baby's border, the pink carpet, and the frilly window drapes. However, at 17 years of age, her parents had decided that her old room was too babyish. Unbeknownst to them, that was precisely the reason that Lindsey loved it. Lindsey loved her old room, her stuffed animals, her pacifier, her bottle, and most of all, her diapers. When she had some, anyway. Lindsey was a teen baby, though no one but her even had a clue about it. She had been into playing baby for about a year now, ever since that one episode of Jerry Springer's show. She had thought the idea to be laughable at first, but then, as her curiosity grew, she discovered that there was a large community of these adult babies occupying the far reaches of the internet. As she delved deeper into this lifestyle, her own feelings were stirred in ways she could not describe at first. Then, one day, she decided to try it out for herself. Ever since that first diaper, Lindsey had been hooked on the idea, buying several baby items, some onesies and sleepers, and other assorted big baby things with her allowance. She usually kept these things hidden under the floor in a secret compartment in her room, but with the construction going on, she had buried them in a plastic tote out in the woods. But she couldn't live without diapers, which she was currently out of. Lindsey turned towards her garage, backpack over her shoulder, and $20 in her pocket. The local drugstore carried the kind of diapers she liked, and today she was intent on picking some up. The only people at the house were the construction crew, and they wouldn't know what was going on inside the house. Her bike was where she had left it, though she had been asked several times to move it so that her parents could get their cars in and out of the garage easier. Rolling her eyes at the thought of her parents whining about something so minor when their own daughter was spending much of her time alone in diapers and baby clothes behind their back, she pedaled out of the driveway and was on her way. Lindsey was about halfway to her destination when something ran across the road in front of her, almost making her fall off her bike. She swerved to avoid whatever it was, almost lost control of the bike, and heard a loud sound, almost like a car honking. Then she was asleep. Oh God. Lindsey thought, I'm blind. I got hit by a car and I'm blind. This was the first thing that crossed her mind as she snapped awake. She took a deep breath and calmed down. She noticed that instead of being blind, her eyes were in fact covered with bandages, probably due to some head trauma. Judging by the ache in her noggin, she was right about her head. She felt around herself and realized she was lying in a not so uncomfortable bed with thin flimsy sheets. There was a rail on either side, but just enough to cover her body, as further exploration revealed that the rail did not extend past her upper thighs on either side. She reasoned that she was probably in a hospital bed. Her clothing, she discovered through feeling, consisted of nothing but a loose hospital gown and a diaper. Lindsey's heart almost jumped out of her chest as she felt the smooth plastic-covered padding surrounding her waist and crotch. How long was she out? Why was she wearing a diaper? Why was it wet? Lindsey was dying of curiosity almost to the point that she was about to take her head bandages off to get a look around, when suddenly she heard someone entering the room. She went still, not knowing who was in the room with her, and she did not want to embarrass herself. Well, Mr. and Mrs. Kluke, Lindsey appears to be fine, a male voice was speaking, apparently to Lindsey's parents, but she still hasn't woken up yet. It's been 2 days, and I expect her to awaken any time now. Well, it was her mom, I hope she wakes up soon. The injuries weren't too severe, we were told, but what about long-term brain damage? Yeah, Lindsey's father spoke up, we need to know if our little angel is going to be the same girl as before. Lindsey's parents sounded concerned, and Lindsey suddenly felt a hand on her arm, probably her mother's. She still pretended to be asleep, trying to ascertain the extent of her damage. She didn't have any broken bones that she could tell, and her brain seemed to be working okay. The fact that she was asleep for 2 days explained her diapered condition, and also the fact that her diaper was currently in need of changing. The doctor spoke again. We don't anticipate any lasting mental damages, though she may need counseling afterwards to come to grips with what happened. Certainly, her mom seemed to perk up, whatever it takes to make our little girl okay again. I just wished she would wake up soon. She'll be fine, hon. Lindsey's dad seemed concerned, but calm. Let's go get something to eat. Oh, and doctor, please send someone in to change her. She's wet again. Sure thing, Mr. Kluke, We'll inform you if anything changes. Lindsey heard everyone leave the room, then started thinking. This could be my chance. I've read stories where people regress to babies. After being hit in the head on the internet, if I can fool everyone into thinking that I had the mind of baby, I'll get treated just like a baby. This will be great. Lindsey's mind rushed on, figuring out all the little details of how to make herself seem as though she had regressed to a more babyish mindset. The first thing she realized was that she would have to start using her diapers like a baby. Not too hard, as that was what she had planning to do when she got back from the pharmacy that fateful day anyway. She knew what she had to do. She relaxed and peed some more into her diaper. A minute or two later, a young nurse entered the girl's room, fresh diaper in hand, as well as a washcloth and talcum powder. As she approached the girl's bed, she noticed something odd. Lindsey was sucking on her thumb and sitting upright in the bed. And she was crying. The nurse noticed the tears rolling down the young girl's face, the way she turned as the nurse entered the room, and the way she was slightly rocking back and forth. She was awake. The nurse bolted from the room to inform the doctor. A few minutes later, Lindsey heard the door open again, this time accompanied by voices. The doctor, her mother, and her father, along with a new voice, probably the nurse from earlier, were all talking at once. The doctor told everyone to be quiet as he approached the bed. Lindsey's diaper was soaked, almost to the point of leaking. She was sucking her thumb, and she was slightly crying. Not really crying, but forcing out tears nonetheless. Lindsey, I'm going to take off the bandages on your head now, okay? Asked the doctor. Lindsey had this planned out. Her only response was to moan slightly and suck harder on her thumb. She could feel the bandages being removed slowly, and soon she could open her eyes. At first, nothing met her gaze but a large bright blur. Slowly, her eyes came into focus and she saw that she was in a normal hospital room. From the evidence around the room, it seems her parents had been staying at the hospital the entire time. Her eyes locked on her mother, she took her thumb out of her mouth, held out her arms and spoke, "Mama," followed by some babyish blubbering. Her mother rushed to her open arms, crying. Her father just stood back, trying to look tough, but eventually succumbed and also rushed to his daughter. "Are you okay, honey? Are you hurting anywhere? We were so worried." Her mother was going a mile a minute, not slowing down for answers. That was fine with Lindsey. She didn't intend to give any concrete answers. She was going to be a baby. Finally, Lindsey's mother let her go, and just looked at her, a slight look of concern on her face. Lindsey had gone back to sucking her thumb and crying while rocking slightly. "What's wrong, honey?" her mom asked, looking scared. Lindsey looked down at her wet diaper, and pulled at the cover with her free hand and burst into a full force bawl. She wanted to be changed, couldn't they see that? Geez, were these people dense. The nurse rushed forward, excess diaper in hand. "Let me take care of this, she's just cranky cause she's wet." The nurse was unconcerned with the behavior of the girl, thinking it best to leave that to the experts. She, however, was a diaper-changing expert. She swiftly but gently pushed the bawling 14-year-old onto her back, unfastened her diaper, wiped her down thoroughly with the warm cloth, powdered, and re-diapered her, all in under a minute. Lindsey slowly stopped bawling, still keeping her thumb in her mouth, and smiled blankly up at the ceiling, drool tracing its way down her cheek. "Doc," her dad almost grabbed the pudgy man, "what's wrong with her? Calm down, please." The doc quickly regained his composure after witnessing the scene played out in front of him. "I've seen this kind of thing before. When some people suffered severe traumas such as this, sometimes they create an alternate personality to repress their feelings. It seems your daughter has done the same thing, but her alternate personality is that of a baby's." The doc shook his head in amazement. "So you're saying she's acting like a baby because she's hurt?" Her mom was terrified. "No, no, Mrs. Klug, it's just a coping mechanism." "So what do we do?" asked her dad. Lindsey was eating this up. They had fallen for her ploy completely. She almost couldn't contain her laughter, redirecting it towards contented cooing and gurgling instead. She was just too good of an actress. The doctor heard the sounds and looked at the girl. "There's a couple of things we can do. It's not safe to try and force her out of it by acting like there's nothing wrong, so we can either treat her like she's acting and let this run its course. With the help of a good counselor, she could be back to normal within days." "Or the doctor trailed off. Or what?" her dad asked, not liking the idea of a 14-year-old baby to deal with. There is a new experimental treatment for these kinds of things, the doc looked intently at Lindsey, who just smiled and drooled back, enjoying the feeling of acting like an infant in front of all these people. Some of my colleagues were working with a sort of sleep hypnosis, in which the subject's repressed personality is brought back to the forefront via subliminal suggestion. It's experimental, but much faster than conventional counseling. Lindsey's mom let go of her hand, which immediately entered her mouth along with the thumb from her other hand, and turned to the doctor. Whatever it takes to get my daughter back to normal, we're willing to try it. All right then, the doctor replied, we'll need to keep her in the psychiatric ward while the treatment is performed, as it will be more comfortable for her in her current state. If you'll follow me, we'll get